a bunch of, right?
Tonight, Louisville catcher Henry Davis, the first overall pick, going to the Pirates. The Sox, they have the fourth overall pick, and they take 18-year-old shortstop Marcelo Meyer. And in international soccer, Italy won the European Championship by beating England 3-2 in a penalty shootout after a 1-1 draw. It's 73 degrees in Boston at 906.
You'll remember what you learned.
There's no easier way to learn another language.
Hola, hablamos español.
He just said, now we speak Spanish.
Babbel, language for life. Now try Babbel for free. Just go to babbel.com. That's BABBEL.com. If you live in Massachusetts, this is your shot to win big. It's the Vax Millions giveaway, and any resident who's been fully vaccinated for COVID in Massachusetts will have the chance to win one of five $1 million prizes or college scholarships. Registration is now open, and if you're not fully vaccinated yet, there's still time before drawing starts. With over 900 vaccination sites across the state, it's never been easier. So get your shot at winning big. Registration, eligibility, and official rules at VaxMillionsGiveaway.com.
Only makes one kind of breakfast, your new favorite one. How do we do it? With fresh cracked eggs, oven baked bacon, and flaky croissants. You know, the things your old breakfast wasn't doing. So toss that old... egg and Swiss croissant, bacon egg and Swiss croissant, and honey butter chicken biscuit are just $2 for $4. Choose wisely. Choose Wendy's 2 for $4.
If it's a moment to delight, give it from price. May vary at U.S. Wendy's.
Brazilian for James.
There we go.
I was just at European.
They need models for men's Brazilian waxes. I thought of you. Free ball wax. And then the number for you to call. So there you go. If you ever want it.
You might have to run that by the fiance.
How would you feel about getting that free Brazilian from some strange woman? That's the show.
You've done weirder things on this show.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I mean, it's kind of weird.
I don't know. Yeah.
Applying hot wax and ripping them off. I don't want to do it for YouTube, though. I want to, my reaction, and also that way everybody knows that there's no inappropriate touching happening.
Yes, exactly.
Reliability and comfort? Sure. Available turbocharged engines? Of course. But also, the driver. And fun, for no reason, except the thrill of driving a car. Kelly Bieber's 2021 is now in play. Contact your car dealer.
Take themselves too seriously is that they take themselves too seriously. We need to laugh. And I people are not finding anything funny anymore, including comedians. But I was thinking, you know, boy, could we use a Will Rogers to just kind of captivate our attention and focus on the goofy part of all this and then have us laugh at some of this stuff. We also need statesmen and statesmen.
Think of, you know, Johnny Carson. When Johnny Carson was the face and voice of late night TV, you know, beloved across the spectrum. You know, he was, you didn't have to be a liberal to enjoy Johnny Carson, and being a conservative didn't mean you couldn't enjoy Johnny Carson. You know, television and public entertainment wasn't as relentlessly partisan. Everything wasn't channeled into a culture war in which you have to be on one side or the other. That's what's changed both with the rise of the internet, as we were talking about before, and just with the fracturing of society, you know, into more and more slices, where every group with a grievance is able to magnify it and get has a huge megaphone to make that be the only thing that they want to talk about.
Well,
it's not healthy. We've lost so much of the sense of having things in common. That's what, you know, how long can a society last and be healthy if the bulk of the people don't have at least some things that we all share in common?
I couldn't agree more, and I think Andy Warhol was right, but I think the people who have gone for their 15 minutes have gone crazy with
their
15
minutes.
They're not letting go.
Absolutely, that's for sure.
We need more tomato cans and less nonsense. Anyway, Jeff, really nice to quote-unquote meet you. I want to maybe share a cup of tea or coffee. We'll meet in Brookline at Optics sometime, you know, away from the marathon route, which may not happen anyway. But really nice to chat with you. Thank you so much, and keep up the good work. People should read Arguable with Jeff Jacoby as well as your column, so maybe you'll pick up another couple.
It's easy to find. Just Google Jeff Jacoby Arguable, and the first thing that comes up is the sign-up. It's free, and 200,000 readers can't be wrong, right?
You bet.
This is a sure sign that you may not be the best driver. A man in New Jersey was trying to parallel park his SUV on the street and accidentally crashed through the front of a driver's ed school. Well, the owner of the place said the guy wasn't actually a customer. Maybe he should be. He was backing into a space out front when he hopped the curb and backed straight through the front entrance right inside the driver's ed school. His SUV caused some major damage to the front of the building.